Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. For today's episode, we're going to talk about the 2021 CRF150L. So as we can see that the 2021 CRF150L has only a few changes. The aluminum magnesium inverted shock or USD is now lightened. Compared to the old CRF150L, it is much heavier than the 2021 CRF150L. The tires on this new bike is still the same compared to the old CRF150L. It has an IRC 2.75, tires 21 inches, 36 holes at the front, and 32 holes at the back. The headlight of the new 2021 CRF150L is still the same compared to the 2020 CRF150L. The decals of the new 2021 CRF150L is still the same, but it has a new texture on the sticker that looks so shiny. In this portion, you can modify this area to add the fittings so that you can easily put grease on it for your motorcycle maintenance. Still, it has a PGMFI technology. The meaning of PGMFI in Honda CRF150L is programmed fuel injection. Programmed fuel injection, or PGMFI, is the name given by Honda to a proprietary digital electronic fuel injection system for internal combustion engines with port injection. The rear tire is still IRC and it has a 4.10 by 18 size, using black rims to add extra aggressive look. It has a brighter red leather seat and it is waterproof. The stock plate holder and signal light with mudguard has a little changes on the designs, but more users will change the underneath of the CRF Honda 150L to add extra good looks at the back. The price of the new Honda CRF150L 2021 has a little changes compared to the old CRF150L. Last year, when I purchased my Honda CRF150L, it was 130,500. Now, it's already 135,000 plus. The front fender of the Honda CRF150L has a little changes on the alignment. It is much more inclined compared to the old CRF150L. The left switches are still the same, with no minor changes at all. The design of this bike is inspired from its elder sibling, the CRF250L. And gets front Showa inverted shocks, large aluminum wheels and headlights. The Honda CRF150L 2021 has still no new skid plate. So when you purchase this new bike, make sure to purchase a good skid plate for your bike and protection. All this similar to the CRF250L. The CRF150L is powered by a punchy all-new air-cooled and fuel-injected 150cc engine that turns out to 12.91 PS of power and 12.43 Nm of torque. The feature list of CRF150L includes pass switch and street, road, off-road, riding modes in terms of safety. Features for console include digital odometer, digital fuel gauge, trip meter, digital speedometer, and display screen. The high ground clearance of this bike and durability make it a good choice for off-roading enthusiasts. The CRF150L is powered by an air-cooled 149.15cc engine based on the TMX Supremo's engine. It has some minor upgrades like different cams, transmission, and electronic fuel injection. The rotor disc of this off-road bike has a slotted disc to ensure that it has a very good braking power. The Calipers brand is Nissan, that is very popular brand when it comes to braking systems. The foot peg of Honda CRF150L has no spikes at all, which is dangerous if you go for a trail. You need to buy a new one so that you can really ride your bike well. In this area, you can see that the throttle cable going to the manifold has a twin cable. In this portion, you can see the level of your reservoir, whenever it's full or low. You can always check this anytime. Its meager top speed of only a little more than 100 km per hour is negligible. Anyway, this bike was not designed with the speed in mind. So that concludes our video. Sa mga bago sa channel ko, make sure to hit the subscribe button and click the notification bell para ma-update kayo sa mga bagong video na i-upload ko. Thank you so much. Bye!